Hi, I'm Shane Hansen with Green Dinosaur. Today we're going to be going over calibration of digital refrigerant gauges. Specifically, we'll be looking at an SMAN 360. You'll need a set of hoses, or at least a single hose and some caps. You'll need a K-type thermocouple, ball type is best. You'll want a glass of ice water and a can of refrigerant. Today we've got R410A. As well as safety equipment and a small flathead screwdriver. So to get started, the first thing you want to do is turn your gauge on and check that the pressures are reading zero with no hoses attached and open to the atmosphere. We're in good shape here, nothing's coming up, but they're both reading zero. If we had anything there, we would zero it out by pressing the cal atmospheric pressure button down at the bottom. Simple enough. Next thing we want to check is that the thermocouples are reading temperatures correctly. So I'm going to plug it into our suction line temperature port right there. That the end of the thermocouple is close to the ice, and I'm reading just over 32.1. We'll leave that, and we'll plug into the liquid line temperature. And we are reading 31.9, 32, right on. So I'm not going to touch those. If those are reading off and they need to be adjusted, you'd grab your flathead screwdriver, put it in the calibration potentiometer here, and give it a little twist either clockwise or counterclockwise until your temperature reads right around 32. So the next step is going to be to connect to our refrigerant and compare our readings to an actual PT chart. So give me a second while I hook up my hoses. I've got my low side connected top bottom, so it's returning to the manifold. I've got my filling line connected the same way. And I've got my high side with one end on, other end open, gonna be connected to our tank. I've also got the manifold open completely so that both pressures should be reading equal. So I'll throw my gloves on and get this connected to the tank. Alright, with it connected to the tank, we can now hook up our thermocouple. It goes on the suction line temperature side, and then the thermocouple itself gets connected to the middle of the canister. Try to stay away from the weld a little bit because it can throw off the temperatures, but stay in the middle of the tank as much as you can. Alright, with the gauge set up and all plugged in that way, we are also set to R410A, which is the refrigerant we're using. I'm going to open up the canister and allow it to fill our line set. All right, so we've got temperatures reading about 70 degrees and pressures reading at about 199. Now we're going to hit the calibrate test pressure button down at the bottom. And it flashes good on both sides within calibration tolerances, and it's good to use. When it runs this test, it's taking your measured pressure and your measured temperature and comparing it to a pressure temperature chart for R410A. If it gets too far off of what the chart should be saying, then it's going to tell you it's out of calibration. If it flashed error on either side, run through the procedure again. Be careful checking that your thermocouples are reading 32 right on, as HERS Raters and Energy Raters, we're required to calibrate our gauges every month. One last little tidbit for you. Here at Green Dinosaur, anytime we calibrate our equipment, we add a sticker right onto the front of our gauge. So when we're out using it and taking pictures of our service calls, we know exactly what the last time that these gauges were calibrated. I'm Shane Hansen in the field for Green Dinosaur.